was a little girl, I always wanted to do tattooing, and it wasn't very fashionable then at all. You couldn't find magazines with it in. It was always in the back of sort of bike magazines that you'd get anything to do with tattooing. So it was really quite an underground thing, and I think that's what I liked about it. I've been tattooing at Woody's for 4 years now. I did my first one about 9 years ago. It was a lot of drawing, just because I knew a lot of the tattooists, I'd draw artwork that they liked. So Woody was into a lot of like 1920s girls, so I'd draw a lot of flash sheets up that would sort of impress him. And it was mainly just sort of trying to get sort of tips off of tattooists, which is not easy. I think it's probably celebrities, like footballers, like sports people that are getting them done. Cheryl Cole as well, when she had the thing on the side of her hand, we got almost every day someone would come in wanting the same thing doing. So I think celebrities have made it very popular and socially acceptable as well now. A lot of my customers are kind of middle class, middle-aged ladies getting tattooed, which you wouldn't have had years ago. It was such a sort of stereotype, whereas now you don't have that anymore. I can't put it into one word. It's quite feminine. It's a lot of sort of geometrical, sort of swirly patterns. I do a lot of pin-ups and sort of women's faces and things like that. But it's quite a broad sort of spectrum that I do, and I quite like that. I don't like doing just one sort of style. I quite like doing lots of different stuff. It's quite fun. If I got to do anything I wanted, it would probably be like a woman's face, maybe sort of morphed with an animal, and just a lot of pattern work. I like a lot of henna and things like that. So yeah, if I got to do anything I wanted, that would be what I'd do every day. But I still quite enjoy doing little butterflies. I think a lot of people assume you want to do back pieces and sleeves every day, but I like doing little dainty stuff as well, so I'm quite happy. There's a lot of shops I found that wouldn't have employed me being a woman, I think, just because of having children as well. At my sort of age, it's sort of childbearing sort of age, so a lot of studios don't want to take women on in case we want to have a family, because then we obviously can't work whilst we're bringing them up. So I think that's the thing. And also I found it's more a lot of other women don't think you're competent at doing it. And they go, oh, you're doing it. And you sort of go, yeah. And they go, can you actually do it? Yeah, I can, whereas I assumed it'd be more men that were a bit more sort of down to him, but it's actually it's other women. It's not a 9-to-5 job, it's not easy. I get up in the morning, I'll do emails before I get to work, then obviously I'm tattooing all day, and then after that, probably have dinner and then get back on the computer and answer emails. I'll be drawing till about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. So it's not as glamorous as they make it look on a lot of the telly programmes. We're not always partying all the time and things like that. There's a lot of hard work involved, but it's so worth it. I love it. I wouldn't do anything else. Rock and you don't stop. Come on. Hey. Nappy boy. It's Travi. T-Pain. Yeah. Hello, Miss Tattoo Girl. How you doing? You are forever. Stuck to me.